Yeah, good day, everybody. This question goes to the Premier. I wanted to ask you a couple of things about AIMCo. First of all, you know, it is set up to have independence. Obviously, I don't think anyone's arguing that. But should the losses have been disclosed to the public, particularly when it comes to heritage?
Sorry, Emma, should what have been disclosed? I didn't hear that.
Should losses have been disclosed to the public, particularly around the Heritage Saving Trust Fund? And does this loss raise questions with the government regarding the amount of risk that AIMCo took on? Should there be consequences? And finally, do you still want to rip Alberta out of the CPP and put all the pensions into AIMCo, given the $4 billion loss?
Well, first of all, let me say, reinforce that AIMCo is the Alberta Investment Management Corporation, is an independent crown corporation. Their investment strategy is overseen by the board of directors. Of course, they do invest funds on behalf of Albertans, including through the Alberta Heritage Savings Trust Fund. And their mandate is to maximize returns. They have a very good track record in having done so. Obviously, like every major investment fund over the past several weeks, they've seen significant losses. I mean, we've seen things are so topsy-turvy, it's hard to follow from day to day, but at least at one point, the Dow was down by over 30%, the TSX by even more. So it is not surprising that we would see investment funds of all scales and all places incurring losses right now. In terms of reporting those to the public, AIMCo does have to report its performance on a regular basis. I believe there's a quarterly Alberta Heritage Savings Trust Fund report, by the way, and obviously there are regular reports to the boards that oversee investments of the various pension funds whose investments are managed by AIMCo. So there is a regular reporting requirement to ensure for accountability. There is, as you know, a standing committee of the legislature that oversees Alberta Heritage Savings Trust Fund investments. And I believe that senior executives from AIMCo appear before that committee to answer questions. So finally, with respect to the future of pensions, we're waiting to receive the report from the Fair Deal panel. That is not about investment strategy, it's about demography. Alberta has the youngest population in Canada, and therefore our participation in the CPP represents a net transfer of wealth from Alberta to the rest of the country. And so I think it's quite reasonable for Albertans to ask whether we would be better off and be able to operate a public pension plan at lower premiums that would help us to create more jobs while keeping those returns here in Alberta. That's a question we're going to come back to once we get through the crisis and once we've had a chance to receive and digest the Fair Deal panel report.